The most obvious, important realities are often the ones that are hardest to see and talk about. Stated as an English sentence, of course, this is just a banal platitude. But the fact is that in the day-to-day trenches of adult existence, banal platitudes can have a life-or-death importance. Or so I wish to suggest to you on this dry and lovely morning.
Well, how do you like it? There's only one word for it. How do you like it?
Terrific.
Only one word.
You know, I'm so proud of it. It's almost indecent.
You know, I'm so proud of it.
I can hardly wait to show it off.
Week from Friday night.
I can hardly wait.
You go ahead and be it.
Week from Friday night.
God got it right. You go ahead and be it.
Week from Friday night.
God got it right. You go ahead and be it.
I wish I was happy.
God got it right. You go ahead and be it.
You having many people? I'm not a mob, but that's
you having many people?
We'll be right back. amendment. She will use any form, a church pulpit, a letter-writing campaign, or television talk shows.
For 700 hours, I've been praying for God to revive America. When word came that there was an ordinance in Miami that would allow non-homosexuals to teach my children, God help us as a nation.
Hold on, I have to hold on. difference between you and with others. When I think of the senator from Jasper, I think of how he touched me with that wonderful biblical speech about Thomas, during our lifetime of faith, described as the finest moment. Yet it was only a few weeks ago. He had so much more to offer that was taken too soon just to be too late. I saw
Don't get burned. Get the facts. Send a stamp return envelope to VD, Box 100, Palo Alto, California, 94302.
Come on,